Before going to the topic, let us revise what is angle. So, when two lines like this line and the other line meet at one point, then they form an angle. You can also say that one line is moving a turn, is taking an amount of turn with reference to the other line, is called an angle. Let me explain you that if you will see the green color line, this line has moved from here to here. So this is the amount of turn which green line have taken with reference to the yellow line. So this is the way you can understand, this is basically the amount of turn. Angle is just amount of turn. So let's move to the parts of an angle. So here you can see a green line and a yellow line. These two lines which helps in forming the angle are known as the arms of an angle. What we call them? The arms of an angle. Understood? Now let's see the next part. Here, where the two lines are meeting, the point of meeting, जहाँ पर वो दोनों lines meet कर रही है, मिल रही है, that point is called vertex. That point is called vertex. Understood? Now let's move to our main topic. So, let's begin with an example. I am taking two arms, this arm and this arm. Can you see that? Yes. So, these two arms are basically like this arm is standing straight on this arm. Is it straight on this arm? Yes. You can see that this arm is basically standing straight on this arm, and when you will measure this angle using protractor, you will find its value, its measure as 90 degree. Okay, and this 90 degree angle is basically known as a special angle, that is called a right angle. What do we call it? A right angle. Okay, now let's see where we can find it, this kind of angle in our surrounding. So here I am taking a clock, a wall clock, and you can see the time over here. So the hour hand of this clock is on 3 and the minute hand is on 12. So what is the time in the clock? See? Yes. The time right now in this clock is 3 o'clock. It's 3 o'clock. Here you can see or compare our figure with this situation. Here the hands of a clock are basically representing the angles of the arms of an angle. So this is one arm and this is the other one. Okay, and you can see that these two arms are exactly this minute hand is standing straight on this hour hand. So they are making an angle of 90 degree. That means this is a right angle. Okay? Now let us move to the next type of angle. I hope these two lines are visible to you. Okay, when two lines are making an angle in such a way that the angle is less than right angle, which is less than right angle. Assume that there was an arm of a right angle. If this could be the arm, then you can say that this line is standing straight on this line. So this must be making an angle of 90 degree, a value of 90 degree. But this actual angle is not right angle, it is less than right angle. It is coming in its own area. So here we can say this angle is less than 90 degree. So whenever the measure of an angle is basically less than 90 degree, or the amount of turn is less than 90 degree, then we can say this type of angle, whether it is of 60 degree, whether it is of 45 degree, koi bhi angle ho. To un sabko hum kya bolte hain? What we call it? We call them acute angle. Call it acute angle. Here you can see that my arm is making an angle. Which kind of an angle is this? Here you can see. Yes, this angle is basically less than 90 degree angle. If I am keeping a scale here, just to assume that this is standing straight on my arm, a half part, then this could be the right angle. So my actual arm, this arm is coming in the area of right angle. So this arm is making an angle which is less than 90 degree. So this angle is called acute angle. Now let us move to the next part. Okay, when the arms of an angle are making an angle which is more than 90 degree, then we call it an obtuse angle. Here you can see that if I am making a virtual line here, this line is basically standing straight on this line. So this would be the right angle. But our actual angle's arm have moved or turned a little more than the right angle. So this type of angle is known as obtuse angle. You can see the turn is more than 90 degree. So here 90 degree se jitna bhi bada ho usko hum bolenge obtuse angle. Kya bolenge? Obtuse angle. Yes. Now let us see again. You can see the position of my arm. If this is the one arm of an angle and this is the other arm of an angle, then the amount of turn here is more than right angle. Again I am taking the scale and I am keeping it here exactly similar jaise maine board pe likha hai. So this is the scale is making a virtual right angle with reference to the lower line, and this arm is making an angle which is more than right 90 degree. This is more than a right angle. So this type of angle is known as obtuse angle. Understood? Now let's move to the last type of angle. Okay, when two arms of an angle are making a turn in in such a manner that these two arms are making a type of angle which looks like a straight line. This is the point, this is the vertex, this is the other arm, this is one arm and this is the other one. So when they are making a type of angle which looks like a straight line, then we call it a straight angle. What do we call that? Straight angle. Straight angle. So let me explain you how it is a straight angle. Let us now again make a virtual line here on this vertex. So this green color virtual line is basically standing straight on this one. True? Yes. Again, see that this green color line or arm is standing straight on this arm also. Correct? So in this respect, it is making an angle of 90 degree. True? Here also, these two lines or arms are making an angle of 90 degree. Got it? So these two are right 90 degree angles, and when you will add them, what you will get? You will get 180 degree angle, and that 180 degree angle is what? Actually a straight angle. Understood? I hope आपको आज की क्लास में बहुत मजा आया होगा. आप लोग इसको बहुत अच्छे से रिवाइज करिएगा एंड यू विल टेल मी अगली क्लास में कि आपको क्या क्या डाउट्स हैं. थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.